Okay, we got it running.
Yeah.
And where's the, I thought you had the mic or something, don't you?
No, we didn't need a mic. Mic is in the form, it's really every other day we can get it in there.
Yeah, I can hear that, but that's the mic.
Yeah. Let's see if we're getting this thing. Let's see if we see if it's got a sound.
Okay, stop it then.
Yeah, the machine's still off. It's about $1,000, and the safe is about $15 a week. So you spent, 3 hours for $15, which is...
Well,
3-hour movie, Gone with the Wind, you can afford it 3 hours. Look how that's the image in the monitor. It's back in. I tried to brush my hair a while ago, so I looked at it. But I can't. It's not like looking in a mirror.
No, not either. What are you talking about the kids? He's gone. Not counting boys.
Okay.
But he's gone. I've got 20 grandchildren. And 15 great grandchildren.
15 great grandchildren. Can you remember all of the birth dates and all the middle names?
I know the names. I know all the names. That's cool.
But the birth dates.
The birth dates, I know the most of them. Sometimes I don't know what year it is. But anyway, the oldest one is 7, and the youngest one was born the 26th of March. So we talked many of those.
Yeah.
10 days old.
Your name's Brady, mine's Jones, so you've been married twice, obviously. Husband's name Gene Jones. What about his side of the family, the Jones side of the family? Do you know anything about that?
His father's name was George Homer.
George Homer Jones.
Now, I don't even know about the Jones family, except there's an aunt there somewhere, and they're all redheaded.
Aunt Effie, and they're redheaded?
Anybody
have some redheaded kids that have someone to play with?
Aunt Effie Jones.
Aunt Effie Jones.
And,
Well, I have an Aunt Effie, but that's not the
one.
That's not the one.
No, George's sister.
Yeah.
And, his mother was Lorella Myrtle Hastings Jones.
Although, so she had been married before.
No, her maiden name was
Hastings. Oh, I see. Okay, Hastings married a Jones. And then George Jones, my grandfather. Dean Jones, Sarah Janine Jones, my father. He had two sisters. One of them named Effie after the Effie.
Effie Glenna. And after Carrie Alfredo.
Carrie Alfredo. Well, I just learned something new.
Carrie Alfredo.
So the strange names running the family. You had three children, me, Danny Marvin Jones, my sister, Janine.
Zelma Janine.
Zelma, Z-E-L-M-A, Zelma Janine Jones, and my sister Joyce, M-A-L-M-A-J-E-L, which is a Cherokee name with you, white dust. Little white dust. Unusual names, not really unusual, but
Identifiable,
that's it.
You have
Mary
Jones, but
that is something different. Right, very cool. No Bob Jones. Now, I have my sister, Jeannie, has how many children?
She had four, she lost weight. She still has Kathleen, Kevin, and Nick.
She has three. Joyce has been married how many times?
Three times, and she has three sets of children.
She has three sets of children.
Bob and Joyce. Ty. And Bob and Judy. Ty. Sylvia, Cindy, and Marcy. Me. And Harry, Kidwell.
And I think that's the end of that. She's 4 years older than me.
She was 52 or 30.
I'm 48, and she's 50, and George is 52. And you're how old?
70. Almost 71. Almost.
70. Yeah, no problem with that. You're going to make that fine.
Yeah. I keep up the mom. She's 90.
And my children, I have Denise, Allie, and Joey. Actually, let's start with the oldest.
Yeah,
okay. Denny Allen Jones. We saw him on the earlier part of the case. And he has two children. He has Denny Richard Jones. Well, let's go back to you. I have three children. Denny Allen Jones is the oldest son. He's married to Lawana Richardson. And they have two children. The oldest is Denny Richard Jones and Gabriel Jones. Gabriel Allen Jones. Isn't that beautiful how we carry that? Not only the last name, but the maiden name with it, but we also are bringing along the first name as far as possible. Oh, Betty's maiden name of Allen, which is, she just picked up somewhere because she's an orphan, but she was an orphan until we adopted her. I married her. So she got this family, she didn't have this family. She's got one now, and Betty Jean Allen Jones. She got married in 52, and she got married in, what, 29 years? Well, let's see, we should have dated this thing to start with. Today is April the 5th, 1981. And so that puts all the ages in perspective. Is this the right word? I know that you're a stickler for the English language. Is the right word in the right place and the right, the proper meaning? That's the answer. Allen Jones. He's married to Ed Mert, and they have two children. They have, Dennis. All I know is Denny and Dennis and Allen. I didn't know the head of his name. Dennis Lee Mert. Oh, that's right. Ed, no, my husband's name is Ed Lee, isn't it? Edward Lee Mert. And so the oldest son is Dennis Lee Mert. And then they have a daughter named Megan Dene. D-E-N-A, isn't it? D-E-N-A-E. Nobody in the family can spell. Ever.
Dene.
French.
Feminine.
Right. Your father's name. Your father's name. Yeah, if you want to grab this family name, take a capital or a letter or a variation thereof. Renee, Vernier, Regner.
You can't have a family any better than that. health-wise and intelligence.
I'm proud to be in this family. Hey, it's quite the simple, you know what I'm saying?
All these kids and no two of them look alike. No two of them look alike. No two of them are alike. They're individuals. No two of them.
That's the way we train them, really. We raise our family. There's no particular, each one should be an individual and think for himself.
Make an individual.
We don't have a family religion or a family philosophy or a family place to live. And we encourage them to be whatever it is they want to be. So we better bring this farmer and we can run it back and
we'll do it. Get it off you.
See if I can focus you in there a little bit. Maybe I can do a better job. Yeah, see that? Looks like it's focused in a little bit. And, well, you've got white here, haven't you? How's that? Let's see, I think it's running here. Let me see if it is, and I'll get back down. Okay. Yeah, we got it running, so I think it's on. I'll wipe off the chair because it's been raining out here.
Well, you ain't working.
I was out here talking to Mom, and it started raining, so I changed the chair and I sit down here in the water. Okay, let's see. I'll introduce you on the tape, because I'm going to keep this tape for a few years. This is Hugh. Well, what's that else in? Hugh Lee Briggs. Senior.
Senior.
Okay, yeah, you got three kids. What's your kids' name?
Well, they've got Hugh Lee Jr. Robert Lewis.
Robert Lewis. I didn't know his name was Lewis.
Yeah. Robert Lewis Brady. And John Richards.
John Richards.
I knew his name was John Richards.
But it was
all named
by Dick. He goes by Dick, and Robert goes by Bob, and
Hugh Lee goes by either Hugh Lee or goes by Hugh Lee. That's called Hugh Lee.
Yeah. We saw Judy around the house when he was younger.
Yeah, he didn't like that number. He was older.
Let's do the show and put this this way and get into the middle of the picture a little bit, Father.
Yeah, there you go.
Wow, that sounds really coming out after that room here, wasn't
it? Okay, you're what, 72?
Well, if we use the word loosely, yes.
You're not sure?
Well, 1970.
1970.
Yes. My anniversary is up here.
Okay, you'll be 72
then. You'll be 73 then.
You're 74 too.
74 too.
Okay,
so
boy,
you've seen World War I, you've seen the Depression, you've seen World War II, Vietnam, and the whole bit.
World War I, I mean, 12 years old, right?
Well, you remember it, though.
In fact, we read it at Junction City.
Junction City, right?
Have you got any brothers and sisters?
Yeah, and you mean left?
Well, I'm hard to say. Oh, yeah, I have three sisters and one brother.
Well, how many is left?
Two sisters and one brother.
Well, I just, we sit out here and bullshit all the time about roofs and tires and neighbors and family and all kinds of things.
Well, I want to get your philosophy of the world, you know. What you think about what's happening?
We're going to have a take, let's put it that way.
And they blame it on the Democrats. The Democrats didn't do it all.
They did it all.
Mostly. There's only some two.
And none of them done any better.
Yeah, they got a bunch in there now. They're not doing any better either.
Yeah, they
Reagan.
Okay. Anything about the replacement rate is going on.
Well, we went up, it can come down.
What is your philosophy of life? When I met the other teenager, he was a pretty
damn
honest guy.
Well,
he didn't believe anybody.
My philosophy is if you make money, spend it and do what you want. I want to travel, that's what I done. Put all my money on travel.
You
know,
no,
well, you're not hurting too much.
No, I'm not hurting the money. I didn't mean that.
You know,
but I would spend the money to other people that matter.
Yeah.
It's pressure.
Yeah.
And I was doing
pretty good money doing this.
But yes,
it is.
I made a lot of money.
But
when the average guy was making, what, a couple bucks a day?
If he's lucky, you know, all five of you. You get a few times if you have your
family. Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
But I said it, and I kept a lot of people. We had more people, family and friends, come to the house, we'd take a kick at. Well, John White was there, you know, he was working for the railroad, had a pretty fair job, and yeah. I know he supported a lot of people, he gave away a lot of food, and I had the opportunity to do it, and did do it. And I don't begrudge it, hell, I can't see people get hungry, you know. But, a lot of people didn't see the way I was doing it. Now, they was all jealous, and they admit it.
Well, you kind of that way even today. If somebody needs something, you give it to them.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that.
No.
I don't like to be taken. That's what I don't want to be taken. I'll give it away, but I don't want to be taken.
He's generous, but you don't want to be taken.
Yeah, no. They can hint to me. If I think they need it, and that's the way I'm doing my kids now. Hell, they can buy anything they want. They don't need nothing from me.
Well, they know pretty well to do off
there.
Yeah.
He don't need nothing. He got no gifts to worry with, and boy, and his wife working.
Well, yeah, they ought to have some of them.
They got money. And Bob and his wife, Colton and Big Business. Dick and his wife and Big Business, so what the hell? Yeah. You just find what they think they need, and that's one thing. Or can you eat, and I do you the same way. You buy what you want.
Yeah.
I don't approve a lot of stuff you buy, but that's your business.
What
don't you approve?
Not all this crap.
You ought to be saving your money, you know.
Okay, well, you're probably right.
Come off the pipe, stuff like that.
Well, yeah, that's a fight promotion. I think that's going to be about a me in there, isn't it?
The last fight, I didn't lose a lot of money on, but I did on the cell phone. The last one, I broke even on it. I think that might be the last one.
Well, when you put that much time and effort and you don't make anything, you wasted your time.
Well, I did waste a lot of time.
Everybody does it different.
My folks done it one way, and I'm doing it another, and you probably do it another, and that's what makes the world go round.
All kids will do it differently.
That's right. You can tell them all you want to, but you can't make them do it.
They get 21, they're going to do what they want to do.
I just tell them what I think they should do, and then they'll go out and do what they think they should do.
That's right, what they want to do.
Yeah. And always the same thing. And
that's right.
The only thing I want to do is not to bother my kids and let them do just exactly what they want to do, because that's what I do. And I don't say, well, you shouldn't do that. Do it this way. I don't say that.
Your family never went through the clothes for you.
Nope.
Only your sisters.
They just say, you're nuts and that's better than a door
guy. Well, I'm that way with my babies, you know, so.
Only wears the clothes. They let you turn. The girls were more or less, but I'm the, well, of course, I never wore the young one too much. But when we split up, and nobody hollers or thinks about it. You know, I say, I don't see why you don't come to see me, but nobody ever come to see me. Holly's the one to go.
Yeah.
How old were you when you left home?
13.
Did you get the health supporting everything yet?
Yes, and you're 72
months. I guess so.
For a while, you didn't carry yourself, I guess.
No, not really. Back in those days, then you get smart for work. And that's what I done. I had a cousin who was sitting down at the school board, so we got smart for work, and that's next thing that comes to the security.
Yeah.
And, 14 years ago, we were at work with the Dragon Ball. I lived at home in Atlanta. We kept out for a couple of years after long enough. And I left it in Atlanta, but maybe 2 or 3 years. I don't remember when we left it out there just then. And then he had it all on to get off. That's what I had. And that's what it is. All of them rolling, and so I got to do what I can.
You're getting pretty rough on yourself,
isn't it? Yeah, if I wanted to stay out all night, I'd stay out all night.
So how long was that?
Well, I started off there, I'd stay out all night, next 16. Which is a good deal back in those days.
You used to smoke out here, I'll do that. You
didn't quit
any of
that,
don't you?
With the 70?
No, I didn't quit till I was 71.
71 years old, quit
smoking.
You laid her down and said, that's it.
That's it.
Well, you don't be great like they were, is it?
No.
After I had my car wreck, I said, look, that's it. I went with that car wreck. That was in the 30s. 1930 something. Oh, I imagine it was 30, either 9, about 38. I said, hey, well, I didn't want to lay on it. I had 5 months. Around the cup, I told him. Did he drop? Yeah, I was drunk. He said, you can't handle the whole deal. Oh, I wasn't blind drunk, but it was in the post farm, and I was leaned over to go around the left-hand turn, and it was right. And you get right on the lead, you know. Pull the car up, and pull me up, and the lady, and it hurt good then, it was really. No, there wasn't, there was a homegrown man. I didn't have a family.
How old were you when you had your first car? What was your first automobile?
1928 Model A.
1928 Model A. When did you do it?
When you were it? Oh, 32.
3-year-old Model A.
It's like a new one, wasn't it? Oh, no, I don't know. And then the next year, I traded it off and got a 31. The 31 is the one I wrecked.
Okay.
And then I traded it off for 30. I bought it. So the 28th, it was the 30. So that's the 30 around the boat.
Yeah.
Then the guy come along and offered me a deal on it. He saved me at 1929. And I drove that a year, and then I traded off to 31. That's when I got the fancy. The yellow wheels and yellow wire wheels and the black sidewalls, black fenders. And then I traded off and got a funeral. That was in 35. And then in 36, I had to buy a Chevrolet from one minute.
Oh,
how many Chevys did you have?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, he had a bunch. I bet you had about 40 Chevrolet and wired together.
Oh,
not like a son of a gun. I had a 36, a 38, a 40, a 41, and a 48, 53, 57. 57, 64, 68, and 76. Quite a few years. I remember the 57 Chevy in Bel Air Hard Top. That was a good running machine.
And the best, one of the best ones, baby.
In fact, the last time I talked to Bob, he seen one down here. And he said, I wish they'd make another one just like it. I'd buy it from that. Well, everybody agrees with that. Just exactly like it was then, and not changed funny.
Yeah.
He had one for over 90-some thousand miles in his but they were evidently in the best cars. Yeah, that's why I was at 50 Mercury's better, so I told him. And that's the problem with it. I'm supposed to keep moving. But he's, died every day. I was buying it.
Yeah.
My cars have a lot more problems today. Some things are better, though. The battery's better. The
electrical
wires are better. The tires are telling a lot better. No, my philosophy of life is to live it as you go. That doesn't say you might not be here enough. I've seen too many guys worry about their wives and goddamn if they've been dead for years and wives are still young. So don't jang it up for the kids unless they need it. Spend it as you go. But I always keep a little mistake just in case.
Well, you spend most of what you make, but you spend it.
Well, I spent, no, I don't know. I'm just kidding. That's why I was like, I get up at 5:01 or at and then I'm all over me. But now it's the woman, $0.15 a gallon, yeah, you can do that.
Yeah.
Well, that would say, what, $1 in the shoulder again? If I had $10, I'd go to Springfield back and I had money left.
I'd have lunch, too.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, and feed the kids, $25. Well, I can almost remember those days. I used to go to the Ozarks, take $20 for swimming for the whole weekend, and take your wife and two kids, and I had gas and boats and everything. Didn't have all that world. So now I worry about getting home. Nowadays, you can't, you go out of the house, especially $25. And then we stop by at the North Pole down there and pick up some bread and lunch meat and some hot dogs and buns and some cold, put it in a cooler and just for 2 days and they offered everything at $20. You see, the things just changed so much. They're going back not a lot like they used to be. We used to load up the old Model Bs. And me and old man and my brother. And maybe once in a while, take a neighbor to it. And we go maybe leave home, the Lone Jack. And a round trip. That's a day trip, you know. And we'd have lunch. And then wind your way back. And we had spent the entire day. We probably took a couple of books. I don't know what it's also a mad day for. And that was a big deal. It's the day we go to Lone Jack, you know. That's special. Well, back in those days it was because you could figure maybe having a flat tire or two. Yeah. And 15 or 20 miles an hour, you know, you go on the roads and pad, they run around every corner of the barn and all that stuff. Now it's a freeway, you know. And cars didn't go past. Nobody did. And there wasn't so many of them either. I thought about that story the other day here, and I saw that note that said, even though it's for you, you know, I thought, that's Christmas note for you.
I'm going to go to the next one.
these people bring them in here, and we can't take care of them. That's why we only had two. I made damn sure we didn't have the three. It's a good thing I did, though. It will end up letting you free.
This is a lot of years.
Yeah.
I had an elephant.
Yeah, I remember. You were a ghost.
Well, I remember you used to fix breakfast and go to work and come home and iron and take care of the house and all that stuff.
That's what meant to you, you know. Yeah, well, nobody else could do it, and I said, no, otherwise.
And you were a single father, and I raised my kids back in the days before it was possible to be a single father.
On the other hand, I raised my kids the same way.
You better get over this way some more, because you're not on that TV, you know that?
Let's bring your chair over this way a little bit.
What you doing, moving?
Well, I think maybe you're going to wobble a little bit up there.
Maybe the wind's blowing.
Yeah, that wind blew us down. Maybe the phone's
the hell anyway.
I ain't looking right in the camera, I didn't see that. Anyway, that's what's wrong with me. And nowadays, well, we used to, we could be all night drunk or something, we could just walk all the way home, where we have to be. Man or woman, nobody bothers us. Nowadays, you can't get out of the house.
Well, you used to be in the way locked your door.
No, you had food all
the
time.
Yeah, whatever you had to. Yeah. I know when I was growing up all my life, we never locked the door.
Nobody
people come in there, if someone was hungry, they'd come on in and eat.
You had trouble, you feared it. Everybody was that way.
You didn't worry about people stealing things from you and go
like that. Nowadays, you got to worry if you buy something, you have to take it down to the bank and put it in the vault.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's true.
But there's a lot of different ways people look at things. Which brings me back to what a guy said one time, and I won't forget this. And I stopped down here to get in the car pit, which had the garage. Just a long time ago. And I asked the guy where he fixed it. He said, well, I gave it a little thought. That's not what I asked him. I asked him, where'd you fix it? He said, well, the first thing I want to tell you, I don't tell you. The next thing, I don't take checks. And I said, about one more piece, if you ain't gonna get the job. Because I don't write checks. And I pay for what I get. He said, well, okay. And if you spend on that, I said, you certainly can. Where's the car? And I said, it's home. And I took it down there and left. He done just like he said. Went by. I didn't get the car down. I said, well, I'm going to work with him. I went to sit here. I said, hey, sit down. Okay. So he got the car down. He said, I don't know the price now. Something less than $100. And I paid him. I've been asked a few times when he told me one day, but I'm sorry I said what I did when he first come here. He said, there's so many people that don't pay me. Since I didn't see you here before. He said, now if you want anything, I don't care. He's down there. And what I'm doing, bring your car down, and I'll help you. And I'll run you in here because most of them say, well, I ain't got the money right now, and you'll have to work another 30 days. And here's check payment for another 30 days. They may end up getting nothing or anything to do with somebody. All that noise, like,
yeah,
we had to get over here and they used to be close together. We didn't get here.
Turn that one around and we're just going to get out of the sun.
Yeah, okay. Okay,
I'll try to go this way.
Yeah. Okay, now I'm going to start again. Just hope for me to see.
No, I tell you, like the other night, he was out there and he was talking and he saw his fire. So we've gone back 50, 60 years. So you have to see your time.
Oh, yeah, you were out there talking about fire.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed that because, you know,
oh, you guys knew all those fellas.
But see, you come with these new ones, and I don't know one from another.
Well, yeah, we talk about boxing. I'm talking about modern day. I'm talking about Sidney Ray Leonard and Malcolm Martin. And you're talking about guys back in 1917, and I don't know them.
Well, of course, you have good fighters back in those days. And really got some today, but not like we have.
Well,
you're talking about back in the 30s.
Yeah.
Nowadays, they fight for the title. They pull five fights.
Yeah, well, right.
There used to be 100 fights or 150 for each ball box. I don't care how good they were.
Because
you had to walk up the ladder. And then you got to be number one, and then you fight for the title.
Well, we had such a lull in
in the 60s, and so Cesare Leonard and Ali came along. I should say Ali and Leonard. There wasn't any good fighters around. Nobody showed them on television. And it was just a good...
we had no television. We didn't even have radio. We had to put them on the
And that was what decided it. But when it comes to purchasing $150, boy, big deal. They got $1,000 bracket. They wouldn't fight him. One guy, he got to be a little terminal. He wouldn't fight another guy like that. He's a big crowd.
Well, let me tell you, it's like this. You,
I'm going to get a $1,000 bill. We used to have circuits. They'd get on that circuit and tell the same joke for a month in the circuit.
Yeah, they'd come up with an act. That act would go every day.
Yeah.
Go for a year, you still have the same act.
Yeah.
And then next year, they'd change it.
Yeah.
Or you'd go the other way.
Now you come up with an act.
So if one night on television, everybody's seen it.
It's all over.
It's all over.
So I have to go back next week or next month with a new act.
The next day.
Yeah, we can't do that.
And they wear themselves out.
And then it's like murder used to be a big deal. Nowadays, it commits murder on TV and in the papers, that even kids ignore it. See somebody out here in the street, they walk right by.
Well, that's true.
Then they don't mean anything anymore. They get immune to it. They get callous. But it's the same thing.
Well, what's the answer to that?
What do you think is an answer?
Yeah.
It's dumb, my answer.
What's the answer?
Because people that kill people, especially worse people, they use clubs, they use spears, they use hatchets, they use baseball bats, they use everything. If they're going to kill people, they're going to kill them. I don't care so what it is. It's the same thing today. You can get that and be it all, or, you know, kill one of the guys off the street. What's the answer to this? There is no answer. Only you have to just think more of what the other guy is. I just told you. One guy don't go down with the other guy. That's what's wrong. How are you going to make people think more about their neighbors?
Well, if they didn't have cars, they didn't have the transportation, we could sit out here and talk, and that guy over there, and that guy over there would be over here, and over here, we'd all here be talking.
Now, I don't see that guy once a month.
You don't know your neighbors.
You don't know your neighbors. You don't know what's going on.
One of the problems.
This guy, the second door down there, his wife had a baby. I don't think anybody's over around here. He never said anything. It used to be, everybody knew it.
Half the people were there on their babysitting and taking care of her or whatever. Now nobody cares.
So we're worried about sex stuff. How are you going to get along? Can you eat and sleep and all that stuff?
Now they don't give a damn whether you eat and sleep or not.
Everybody's working out for themselves.
That's right.
It's all detail. If you can't make it, it's up to the government to take care of it. Just like these guys up there at General Motors right now, I want a $2 an hour raise, and I don't care if that guy's walking the street. Because he's going to have a job, I told you every day, same thing. Now, there's something wrong with people that do that. There's the same thing that's wrong with the people that on release, and they said, boy, I don't know what, how we're going to do it, and they're sitting there puffing a cigarette and drinking a can of beer. Now, he don't give a damn. He figures Uncle Sam's going to keep them. Uncle Sam's doing it, and that's what's wrong with the country. And people say, well, I ain't giving you no more. You're on your own. That's what we used to do.
We had a poorhouse in the area. It was a
terrible, but somebody went to the poorhouse. So you kept your mother, your father, or whoever. If they had something wrong with
it. It was matter of pride.
Yeah.
Nobody cares anymore.
No, there's no pride.
You get food stamps or government handouts today, nobody gives a damn.
They brag about it.
Yeah. You run down and see you get more.
That's right. They don't do that.
You know, they're
called, well, they lost something. There's no respect.
go down the road, they'd chase right and run over you. And if they were 50 miles an hour, they'd drive 60. If you say 60, they'd drive 80. What do you think about the 55 mile an hour speed limit? Nothing wrong with 55 mile an hour speed limit, only it won't work. You tell people that's what it is, forget it.
Well, you think they should have a 55 mile an hour speed limit and then enforce it? Or do you think they should make it
work? Couldn't get enough people to enforce it. He's like this guy right here. You see him parking, blocking the sidewalk, that's against the law. You know him doing it? The guy down the street, he's parked on the wrong side. Two of them.
Yeah.
They know different.
But do you do it?
They don't know.
You think everybody just does this thing and nobody gives a damn?
They don't care.
Nobody enforces it.
They don't. Everybody's got the laws, they don't enforce it.
When I was a kid growing up, and you stayed out till 9 o'clock at night, and you asked on a telephone pole, and you went home. You can go home, be well the hell out of you. Nowadays, the other kids are going, you hit me. They sue you and get damages. That's what's wrong with the country.
The world is in trouble.
Yeah.
You have to start from scratch. The kid goes to school, your teacher can't protect him, can't whip him, you can't do nothing with him. The college mother will come up, and the woman said, when I get around to it, I'll be up there. Leave my kid alone.
Yeah.
The kid, the mother's allowed to come up and smack the teacher in the mouth. Correcting her kid. I'll correct him. That's what I'm for. You just tell me, and I'll do it.
But then she doesn't do it.
Then she don't do it. That's the idea.
So we
you think not enough discipline there?
That's
the problem.
That's the whole thing in a nutshell.
And there's no kid, I don't care how old he is, he don't know when he does wrong. Because you can watch the kid and just, oh, what? Goodness. And his mother said, well, we're going to change for the house. You don't get into nothing. You don't do this and you don't do that.
Yeah.
And pretty soon you don't hear anything and you get to watch him and you look all around and hear anybody watching.
That's part of the torture.
Kids can do that.
I remember that.
They test you.
Yeah, they test you.
They test you out.
And if you don't stop them, why then now we'll go to your father and test you again.
When I was going to school, I didn't dare go home and tell my mom. Teacher with me about getting old.
Part of the problem then, or the biggest problem then with society, you think, is there's no discipline.
There's no discipline.
Everybody wants to do is say,
all prisoners are just for us, Mark. Don't whip your kids. Don't whip your kids. They didn't stand in the corner. Don't whip your kids.
He said, well, how do you press yours?
Well, I've done the complaining to his room. His room, he's got radios, he's got TVs, he's got everything. He worries.
He got to live in there for 6 months.
Why, hell yeah. He gets hungry because he's just
away from
the school system.
So there's no discipline. They don't, no respect for authority.
There's no respect for authority. They just grow up. The more they grow up, the worse they are.
It reminds me of the comment.
There's no difference between the comment and the good business.
If one is locked up in there, it's not.
One guy said, well, he's seen him. He's heard that from one. That's the difference.
Both legal and one
isn't. That's right.
He's got a run up.
And now it's to the point, and it's all over the paper if you read the paper, white collar crime. They ain't hurting nothing to them people. They could steal $10 million. They get 5 years or 2 years, they're out walking the street. If you go out there and hold up somebody for 15 cents, you get 10 years and you do buy them. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
There you
got that. Now they're better than leave because
yeah.
It costs you damn much to keep them in jail.
So,
as far as politics is concerned, you're a Democrat, right?
That's right.
You're a tender gas
Democrat. Well, not necessarily a tender gas Democrat. What I believe in is since I was a working man, I wasn't a white collar man, and I can understand why white collars are white collars and why they're Republicans, because they got their vote. And, but nowadays, they said, well, we need to change administration, so we got it. And the first thing he does is jump on the war gun. He done knocked us out. Yeah, he hurt me too much, but he did. He took a few dollars away from me. I don't know, I'm Social Security. I can't help myself. He took the lid off the oil, which helped these guys. They got millions, billions of dollars out of it. And they're still getting it. And that's a big deal. And now he says, well, I think the welfare stamp. Who's he jumping on? He's jumping on the little guy can't help himself. That's the Republican.
He's just taking the second welfare stamp away from the rich guy, too.
That's what you think.
Okay. How about, that's politics.
That reminds me of...
How about religion?
That reminds me of the guy... Wait a minute, let me get this off my mind. The guy said, well, we'll get a 10% raise. He said, don't you think that's wonderful? I said, I don't think it's so high. He said, what the hell's wrong with you? You get as much as I get. I said, yeah, if you're making $40,000 a year, I'm only making $5,000. That's what's wrong with you. So you get 5 times as much as I do. Well, I'm worth more. That's the first thing he's going to say. I went to school. I said, so did I. But I said, what do you say when taking this consideration? I eat different much as you do.
The gasoline cost as much as
you do. That's right. Then he said, well, that's not my fault. That's you.
Okay, that's the Democrat politics.
That's
how about the religion? What do you think about religion?
I think everybody ought to do just exactly what he wants to do.
If you want to go to church and be a Catholic or whatever, you do it.
If you don't, that's your business. But don't criticize somebody that does, and that's how they make any difference what they do. I raised my kids, if you want to go to church, and I took them to church, that's what I want to say. But you can go to any church you want. I don't know if they're going out now. I think they're there, so I don't think the rest of them do. And I know I don't. But when I feel like going out, go to any church, I take an oath. I don't feel like it very often, you know, that's all I do. But I don't criticize the Catholics, because I was raised with Catholics. But I never was Catholic, you know. I believe that if you believe in religion, and I believe in religion too, after in a way, to a certain extent. But I think if you live a good life, an honest life, and you're honest with yourself, I see no reason to go to church if you're a believer.
Okay, well, then you're not against the Jews.
No,
you're not against the Baptists or anybody else.
I don't know, they could be just as right as anybody else. I could be just as right as any of them, but not going to any of them. But I'm not an atheist. By any means.
And just politics. What do you think about communism back to politics for a moment?
That's what this country's going to. The government's telling everybody what to do now. That's all communism is, in my opinion. I can see no reason, Mark, that I can't get my money and spend it as I see fit. Why should I have the government?
Well, I'm going to use that to do
that. You think that to do that. You believe in less government.
And that's right.
That's right.
Yeah, it's me. Oh, yeah, okay. I guess you had to warm the camera up there.
Okay.
Where were we? We're going through religion. We went through politics.
Now you talk about communism. Oh, you're not on here for some reason.
Let's move the chair over this one.
Let's move the chair over this one. I believe he's blown that.
Yeah, I know. I don't call him that.
What happened? Over there, then you don't get the money in the first place. Over here, we get it. The government takes it away. Then they say, well, here's 15 cents. You do it this way.
Okay, but what the hell do you think we should do about it? Should we get into the subject like Vietnam again? Should we ignore it? Should we let the communists do it? What should we do?
Well, I don't have any solutions for it. I think the people should be allowed to spend their own money. I can't see any sense in the government taxing all these taxes and say, now, I'm going to take 10% of your salary, and I'm going to take 10% of everybody's salary. And the next thing you know, it winds up over there in Africa or someplace. People starving, they're starving over here, see?
Yep.
But we're feeding them people over. I don't see that. Let's go here at home. You say, let's take care of us.
Okay. So you think America should be for America.
That's right.
That's first.
Okay. If we got an excess, yes. So you got a household, you take care of your household. If you got an excess, then you look.
If we're running a hole to take care of it, we're borrowing money to give to them, that's silly, isn't it?
That's stupid. They said, well, we only do that because we want with an ally. They're not allies.
Soon as you quit giving them money, they turn communism.
You can get $1 million and you'll have a million friends. overnight.
Right.
You get rid of your million, you don't have nobody.
Well, you said that about the Depression. As soon as you're handing out money, everybody's your friend. Yeah. So all you got to do is hand out money, you're buying friends. You don't, they're not friends.
You're buying them.
Those guys aren't friends at all. Right?
But as long as you know that you're doing it, and you feel better for doing it, then you have done the right thing.
If the guy wants to starve afterwards, that's fine with doing it.
We've gone through religion and politics and just economy. How about marriage and birth control pills and the modern family life? What do you think about that?
I think all families should be limited.
I believe in abortion. I believe in legalizing abortion and enforcing it.
That's surprising. The man was your age
and growing up when you did. That wasn't an accepted thing.
I said a long time ago, I didn't think I could take over care of over three kids.
And if everybody felt like,
how many kids you got?
You got three.
Yeah.
But
how about the rest of
the these guys on release, they stay home and that's all they do. Just have one kid right after another so they get more money. They should pick those women so they can't have them.
They're sterilized both of them if necessary.
Three kids is it.
The same guy, he said, well, they went out here and he shot somebody.
Like this guy shot the president. They knew that guy was there.
Castrating to start with, that's not bad. These guys are right, castrating. They ain't gonna do it again.
Well, don't wait then until they do castrating.
Right. If you think that a guy's got a damn good chance to do something like that, just might be about to start.
If he has a judge in pain one time, he still has pain in my opinion.
Just put him away and forget it.
That's right.
So, don't just keep telling with him that, oh, we'll bring him back. We'll bring him back.
Like I believe that they say, well, they put them on the respirator or whatever, they keep them alive, and they're nothing but a vegetable.
I tell they measure take its course.
That's the same, you know, that guy's
called euthanasia, isn't that it, where you can let people die
if
they want to die?
Yeah.
So don't keep them alive. And you believe that if you were in a position where they were keeping you alive as a vegetable,
you wouldn't want to be that way.
You would rather, well, you would get permission, or you would tell the doctor if you were able to, pull the plug, or
hell
put
yeah.
Let me go.
Just like if I see a guy up here on a big tall building, he's going to jump off, let him go.
What's that, doctor?
That's what he wants to do, let him go.
He won't do them, huh?
Just don't do that one,
just that, just one.
Okay.
But that's
economic.
We didn't really hit economics very hard.
What do you think about it?
How do you think it's
just like they're throwing the ball there?
All you gotta do is watch it. It'll come down.
Get the money?
Well, yeah. Everything's gonna come down. Everyone else will come down.
Do you think there'll be recession? Then it'll go up later to inflation, and then it'll be recession again.
You see, all we have is ready inflation. It's all over the world.
That's here.
In this country, it's all over the world.
And they're having inflation over there in countries that don't have nothing.
Oh, some of the worst of that.
Sure they are.
It's 100% a year. We're talking about 10, 20%.
Well, I don't have any solution for it. I know that we had the market price in 1929. I remember that.
Did you lose any money?
Did you lose your money?
I didn't have any money.
You didn't have any to lose.
I didn't have any to start with.
But a lot of people did.
I'll tell you what, I think you ought to.
Well, what do you think?
You know, I'm starting to drop it, too.
Yeah, I'm starting to drop the rain here, but
no.
It won't get the cloud.
Yeah.
No, I don't have any poison, but I got news for you. We've got a lot of people up there that's going to support our meat.
Yeah.
And they don't have food yet.
Well, that's what worries me. They run group after group through there, and they all got the answer for a little while until they get in there, and then they find out they don't have it either.
And, yeah. There's no answer. But if everybody all over the world would freeze everything right where it is now, it wouldn't be so bad. But they don't do that. Now, it's to the point that when, like they decontrol the oil, first thing it does is go sky high. Big business has beaten the whole world, just like the people have been doing. The milk industry. They subsidize all of them. But they don't subsidize railroads. That's what we need. So they take this stuff, and coffee's another one, and sugar, until they got warehouses, they don't know what to do with it.
Yeah.
But they keep the price up there, and then suddenly, they say, well, what are we going to do? Where's the guy that's looking at the oil right now? They don't have any place to store it. They can't sell what they got.
Yeah, but if you're limited to that, they can run out of, what, 15 or 20 years or
more. I don't know.
But well, you agree with that. You do agree with that, don't you?
Yeah,
it is limited.
Well, yeah, here's what I agree on. Here's what I say. I'm talking big business. See, there we hit them. They got all of them. They got all the things right there. They got everything right there. They said, well, we can't do anything with field costs and we can't move up without all the costs and that's not at all. They must sell it, they stop it. They're going to eat that problem. It's all boiled down like time, like something, okay? You have to admit. Conserve. You do, they raise price.
Yes, you lose, no matter what you do.
You can't win.
Yeah.
That's the monopoly. They say, well, we can't have a monopoly, but they got it.
Yeah.
That's it. So you're sitting down here, and the man's sitting up there, and you're sitting under there, and all you got to do is reach this down and push it. And that's what he's doing. So if you get a book, just push it out. What do you think about atomic energy?
There's nothing wrong with atomic energy.
You think they should build atomic plants and make them generate electricity?
If that's what they want to do, let them do it.
To grow up, to grow up. My age is only for good.
No, as long as they make cheaper electricity.
Like my uncle said one time, I was just going past the damn car and he said, that's driving a little fast. And I said, well, I'd drive faster if I could. I don't know what the hurry is. He said, now, myself, he said, I don't care. Because I'm an old man. I've already lived my life, but you're young. You've got a lot of ways to go. And if I were you, I'd be right close up.
That's a bad way to go.
Yeah, let me turn this thing off.
Yeah.
Well, maybe I can sit down right beside you there.
And then,
It's not efficient,
And you get goop and scratch.
Well, it's gonna look good.
Yeah, it's gonna look good.
You better open the teeth and it's gonna look good.
Sometimes you get rid of better stuff than what you buy. Because they're gonna get rid of the stuff that got it on the end, they're gonna get rid of it. So the dust pass them all, it's got to be sold in front of the
kitchen. That'll keep it.
And that'll protect it.
Yeah.
It's not what you give for, it's what you get.
That's right.
But sometimes you can buy, you can pay more and get a piece of junk.
That's right.
I think something comes out in down there.
They look good and really it's nothing.
That's the guy down there, you know, he's what the fish is down there, I don't know. Well, he don't know where fish is, you know, they didn't go.
Yeah, we ought to get the book out and find out because he made it.
You know him a couple more.
You better believe it.
He's very light grown. Like he said, when I have my own, it's 11 years. That doesn't mean anything.
Sometimes,
you know, that's where I think he's $100 a month after that electrician. That could have been a fortune. He wasted.
But he don't run his ass in time. He needs a ball for a million dollars.
Well, that may not be the best either.
And, sometimes that don't save you nothing.
He said, I don't care if he's going to lose his money to the end.
That's what comes home at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and turns it on, and that thing has to run wide open for 2 hours.
You got your savings.
And, yeah, if he'd have left it on in the morning when it was cool, it wouldn't have got hot.
So he would have walked in to a cool house when it came home.
He said, I can't imagine you just leaving me in.
I don't think you're saving anything, and if I did, I would be money that way, but I don't think you are.
I said, because when I go off and go from the 5 days, I turn it off, and when I come home, I said, it takes me about 2 hours before it comes off the first time.
He also 5 minutes, then he runs 10 minutes at that time.
Yeah,
he says, I said, it's got to cool off, and then in the same amount, before it was perfect. So I said, I don't think you pay me a lot of money. Pay me a lot of money, thank you.
Get back to that stuff that guy told me, because you know,
that, like I said, you just wash your hands and they just replace it.
Yeah.
So don't kick on for your fish.
Yeah.
You got red oil on it.
So you save that.
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get me a fuel burner and
one that
doesn't have a pilot go all the time. And go on vacation, turn it off. And I can,
yeah,
in a year's time, save a couple hundred
pounds.
Okay, now we can have to jump up here with you.
Well, I adjusted it some color a while ago.
Oh, you can't, that doesn't look like this color.
No? Well, the color is
well, you can't just know. Yeah.
Well, so really what you see here is a little different than what you see when I get it in the house.
It's
a little brighter and darker than the house.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it appears a lot, but right now it's This is the same date and time as I did you just a few minutes ago. It does be easy, but that's on that thing. It's on that thing. Yeah, we came with this, and I adjusted the camera to color and so on. I'm rolling up this on the 6th near the center. April 12, 1981. Yeah, I did the early part of it, but we didn't pay the general on the
Thank you.
that has always been in it. There'll be another year. other things in the basement.
Somebody in the basement, mine, got the wash and dryer, and people say, well, those are here.
Yeah, we're not worried about that.
Well, I'm not.
How about your, you have more pictures left, though?
Yeah. And I've got pretty divided with pictures, along with two in this vendor and one box later.
Okay.
And all my pictures are in another box later.
Okay, you get two pictures, about those two ways. So,
But long as they say that, that's what they're doing. Yeah. because you couldn't have killed it.
Well, you could have it written wrong in the deed, or maybe it doesn't go to you.
Well, there might be just one or two letters.
There may be a problem. A lot of times when it goes to the state or goes to the court, you may have to fight for something that's already yours.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I didn't think I had to because I was helping him.
Well, that's right.
He willed everything to me.
Yeah, if one of you had been married with no children and no businesses and no other problem
in
there. But what if you had a half a business in partnership with somebody with some stock that wasn't really all, you know, that you couldn't sign, and had kids that were your kids and my kids?
And I think I told Danny before, you know, when I started setting up and going here and then going, instead of putting the mine in all that he was deceased, it would have been the one place for that. Did we have this? And I said, yes. He wrote everything to me. He did it from when I read it.
Yeah, but the problem, but there's a problem after you, you died. So now you have a problem. See, there isn't an automatic person to take it over. You could go on auto
Well, I'm going to let him do it.
Well, you've already taken care of it.
Yes.
Otherwise, it goes into probate and everybody in the world can fight over it and the government will never have that. What did it cost you to get?
This time he got
Introduce yourselves with a date.
Just tell us what you want.
Ain't that sweet. Producer, director.
I got it in a soap box.
Still has a soap in it. This is April 18th, 1981. Oh, it's just past your birthday. Your birthday is what, the first?
Third.
First?
Well, Bob, see, I was 18 when Bob was born, and Bob just turned 27.
I can remember you as a little girl, and you were awfully big for your age.
No, you don't remember me, but it was me that was big for her age. I was always very small for my age.
When I was a little bitty boy, you were a lot bigger than me.
Well, you're awfully small.
Now,
you're only
39,
so I can't.
Oh, yeah, that did it.
It fits now. You're 39? I'm 44
years older than
you. How come I'm 45? I don't
even
know. How did I get to be older than both of you?
I lied about my age.
Well, what did you tell you about Bob having two birthday cakes? Well, he was 26. The original was 27. But Dan said, of course, your other dad was like mine. But she had a box. But she bought two things. One of them had 34, which is his real age. The other, 627. And it's
two. Two birthday
cakes. Well, the piece of reference is, you're born 1929, but you're only 45.
Right.
But if you're born in 1929,
Well, actually, now, Harry Tidwell has 1929 on his driver's license.
Okay.
Yeah, but I'm 9 years younger than him. So he was born in 29.
Okay, why don't you do this though? The date. I say who you.
Now how old am I?
It doesn't really make any difference how old you are if we don't know who you are. We didn't say who she was, honey. That's all our
deal. I told
you
I was Betsy Hitler.
Just for, like, we have a picture of great-grandpa to admit, remember, on the rock in the Civil War, maybe you've never seen it. I would like to know. Okay, I would like to know things about the guy. I mean, where did he work? What did he do? Did he fight in the war, or did he get wounded in the war? Was he a carpenter? Was he a ditch digger? What was it? Who are you, and what are you? So that 100 years from now, somebody looks back and says, you know, not just a picture of this woman. I mean, what do you believe? Who are you? What have you done in your life? You've been married.
Not a
trick
kid. He's not a trick kid. He's got
mine, grandson. Yes. Okay, how old were you? Okay, you went to Central High School. You went to. Well, you didn't go to Central, did you? With the rest of us. Did you go to Central? I thought you already.
Okay, I went to kindergarten then. I went to Morrisville, a grade school.
Me too.
Okay, until my 7th grade. In the middle of my 7th grade, we moved to Kentucky, Illinois. So I went to 8th grade, and freshman year of high school in Kentucky. We moved back to Michigan, Kansas, and I went to Shawnee Mission High School. When we moved
to North, it was the only Shawnee Mission at the time.
Yeah, I was the only Shawnee Mission.
Okay,
so then we moved in on Bell Fountain, and I went to Central High School.
Okay. All right, your name is Joyce Mahale, M-A-J-E-L. And then give us the rest of the name. Oh, let's see.
Joyce,
you got married. What, you got married?
Ty. Me. Kidwell. Oh, I forgot Kidwell. Kidwell, my name. Okay, Jones, Ty, me, Kidwell. That's terrible.
Well, you run out of fingers. Maybe that's a good sign.
We were talking about, you know, these names on it. I just said, yeah, they can have a wrap around my head.
Right.
I went sunshine on mine, and I saw one yesterday, and had sunshine. That's my hand.
Yeah.
It's somebody else. I didn't think, wow, that'd be
What extra letter? They left the E-R.
I mean, they say Diane, and I want to start Thank you.
It looks like
worsened. What he has there, he is a funny-looking guy with glasses left his teeth.
Yeah.
But this, what was the restaurant we went to?
Bristol.
There's a seafood restaurant. I came over here to spend the night with her because we wanted to get started from here early the next morning. And she wasn't here, so yeah. I'll have dinner. But I went over and spent the evening and So anytime you get a bathroom, this will be pink.
Yeah, I
like that.
Part of the ball that, what do you call it, nerve?
The nurse falls. The nurse? Yeah, it's the nurse falls.
Exactly what it is.
Somebody asked her what was a canal. You know what
no, it's a neural.
Canal. You know what a canal is?
No, I know what a neural is. That is K-L-K-A-U-R-L. And it was on the side of the carton at work. The thing is, what is a canal? And I said, you don't know what a canal is? I said, it's like a canal or a tree.
But she was talking about, I don't think much about it when you told that. Oh, she did. I don't think she did. She was kind of like, she wanted to
well, what I brought it at was
Cindy.
No, Cindy was saying to Brandon, don't you know? No.
That's
about enough. She didn't say.
She said, don't you know?
No.
She meant, don't you say N-O-W-N-O. But she said, don't you know, no?
When I tell you no, don't you know, no?
God, you guys are brilliant.
No, she did. She said, don't you know, no?
When
the child's going to say no, no.
In your previous life, you must have been an English
teacher. Thank you, sir.
She accuses me of that. He's accusing me of that. Well, that's a little thing my told me over there. I was expecting you to you were in kindergarten once your first
oh,
grade.
Oh, absolutely. Tell me the story then I'll make
anyway,
you know
what anyway, every time you couldn't mispronounce the word or get your sentence jumbled up or something, I'd stop you and ask you to step correctly. Oh, she's not going to listen. You ain't just like a little school teacher. You can't let those kids talk unless they say, that's exactly right.
Now, answer your question. Okay, I was born April 3rd, 1929, in San Francisco, Kansas. I was named Joyce Mayo. Junk, right?
Mayo means it's
a little white dust.
A little white dust.
Little white dust, like, right.
And you was, your father's name was?
Jim
Barrett. Jim Barrett. You're as bad as I am. Don't even know your father's name. That makes sense as I can, right? So wait, don't get rid of him. What's your mother's name?
Oh, you know when he was born? April the 13th, 1905.
I didn't know that.
April the 13th, I thought all day long about his name. I thought about him the whole day. He would have been 36.
Well, he was a very honest man, very strong man.
He was honest to a fault. And he was a little down his shirt.
That was a little funny.
You remember he was walking all the way down there taking his sandwich?
Well,
that was a treat. And they had a White House,
And the only way you make it is where it's delivered. You've got to drop it.
Well, your hamburger comes in a great big chunk, and you have to shake it sometimes.
Nevada?
No, in the Bay Area.
No.
No. Okay, it was east of, what was it? That was Springs, wasn't it?
Wow.
It was?
Right.
No, wait a minute. No, it was because it was east of Nevada.
And he was World War II, he was a tail gunner, and he was a lot of metal.
17 months in the concentration camp.
Solid 17. He was a solid 17 season. And...
What was in that thing?
My next thing? I think it's not. I'm looking at it. Okay, and he went to work.
He was born in Phoenix, Oklahoma. His grandfather, Norman, is where Norman, Oklahoma, gets his name. It's from Bob's grandfather, Norman Blanche's father, because he made the run for the, it was 1890 or whenever they had that.
Long time.
Harry was born, Harry Jr. was born in 1974.
Okay, well, with your first cousin Bob, he lived in Independence, Florida. He built a house that looked like a barn.
That's the way I think about it. That's why I'm a There's more good in life than there is.
If I had a choice, I would not. If I had a choice. You know, I mean, you can choose to live or not to live. My father, he had a choice. He chose not to. And I think he had the right religion. I think he had the right religion. I do.
Oh, that's good.
You didn't know that.
Half the people in the world are trying to live on the line to get another day if they can land there.
Gee, it's better to go. I'm going to stick around and see how good it can be.
No, this is what I feel. Okay, I have to go to work. So I can attend it on the call. And get dinner from that call.
Then it's no work.
So I can go to work.
You see, it's all really good. It's all really good.
Okay, you got it?
Yeah, no, that's
it. You made the circle.
That circle keeps going on and on.
It's terrible.
Well, it's only terrible if you don't enjoy it. Just like that. Spending money on your work to buy the food that you can put to work. It's always everything is that circle.
No, I go home and I take something really ill and try to take it off, then I get up and go looking at it.
What part of your life did you enjoy the most?
The year that I had a family. The year that I had the child. But I don't know what it is. I don't see it.
What about with a senior high school? What about if you're a freshman in a senior high school? What about if you're a
senior high school? But I was so dominated, I couldn't get my grades.
I was tough times too, but see, you never did get scared.
Yeah, no, I could make it back to grade. I finished going to summer school, trying to make up the grade that didn't match the year before.
Yeah, I fought that one time, and I fought that too. Yeah. You didn't go through that again.
Yeah.
I made pretty good grades, though, really, when I set my mind to it. But see, I was worried about other things. Other things were more important to me than making the grade. I guess I couldn't make the grade. I mean, it was like a guy in prison, they say, well, he's not a sociable person. And my God, he can live 20 years in a society with a bunch of nuts, crooks, and rapists and still survive and still come and leave. This guy can survive in society because, hey, that's a test of whether a man can survive or not. And what I'm living in is a test.
Why struggle to survive?
I'm not struggling to survive. You are. See, I'm enjoying life. I'm like Joe Mason. He said, I can't wait till tomorrow because I get better looking every day. Well, every day in my life.
Well, you listen to the
No, you're a wonderful life. You're a beautiful baby boy, I'll tell you.
You know what's bad about that? My mother said, you have a face that only a mother could love.
I did not say that.
Oh, what did you just say?
I thought that I was not a good one. And the other one, you got on a little leather jacket and a plain one. Those are two best pictures of you.
Grandma Brady, Grandma Brady, stole that picture out of it. She stole it.
Don't you think that one of them in the little letter jacket is Marvel? He had a finger there. He said he was ugly. He wasn't.